Hey guys, so the Apple Watch Series 6 was announced back in September and it's finally available in Malaysia last month. But if you're still thinking as to whether you should upgrade your Apple Watch to the latest one, here are some reasons why you should or shouldn't. Now, if you're wearing the Apple Watch Series 5 on your wrist right now, then I'm just gonna say there is no need for you to upgrade to the Apple Watch Series 6. Personally, I think the improvements between these two watches aren't that huge. For example, the S6 chip is faster than the S5 chip by 20%, but if your Apple Watch Series 5 is still just as smooth and responsive, then why are you wasting your money? It's like only a year after all, so if I were you, I'd wait a few more years before I actually upgrade. The same goes for the battery life that is supposedly improved. So they say it's better, but both watches offer up to 18 hours of battery life. The only real difference is the Apple Watch Series 6 charges faster, but if you still have to charge it every day, then it almost doesn't matter unless you're rushing out and you forgot about charging your watch. What really matters that may push you to upgrade your Apple Watch Series 5 to this is if you really want that blood oxygen level monitor, or you think that the always-on display on your previous watch is not bright enough. So the latter may seem insignificant, but there have been a lot of complaints previously, so if you're one of them, then you might want to get the Apple Watch Series 6 because it's 2.5 times brighter when it comes to its always-on display. Of course, if you don't use this feature, then this doesn't apply to you at all. Apple also added the U1 chip in this watch, and it's mainly to detect short-range wireless locations. So it can be your digital car key in the future, or even work with Apple's upcoming AirTags if that's even happening. Basically, the Apple Watch Series 6 is kind of future-proof, but if you can wait another year or two, then I'd say skip this watch. Alright, there's also the always-on altimeter, but I feel like most of us probably aren't even hikers, so unless you need that real-time data, again, this is not a legit reason to upgrade your watch. But if you're using the Apple Watch Series 4 or older models like this one, this is the Apple Watch Series 3, then I think it's time for an upgrade. The performance is significantly better and faster. Plus, these older models don't even have an always-on display. They have smaller storages and they don't have compass if you're someone who uses that. They will also miss out on future software updates, but to be fair, the Apple Watch Series 4 should last you at least another 2 years. If you're wearing the Apple Watch Series 3 and older watches, then it's time for you to upgrade because you'll be getting a bunch of new and improved features. So apart from whatever I've mentioned earlier, you're also getting an improved digital crown. You get the option for GPS and cellular variant. There are better speakers and mic, there's fall detection, you get better chips, better Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. As compared to the Apple Watch Series 5, those wearing the Apple Watch Series 3 will have more practical reasons to upgrade. So basically, here's what I think. If you're using the Apple Watch Series 5, then don't upgrade. If you're using the Watch Series 3 and older, please upgrade. And if you're using the Apple Watch Series 4, then it's really up to you. But if you think that you can't afford the Series 6, which starts from 1,749 ringgit, then perhaps you can consider the Apple Watch SE, which starts at a price of 1,199 ringgit. So that's it for our video today. If you actually got yourself the Apple Watch Series 6 or even the SE, feel free to share your experience with us in the comment section down below. Remember to like this video, if you like this video, and subscribe to our channel, KLGadgetTV. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.